Mazda. It just feels right.
After Bill Glass.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum for today's West Regional Final between the Loyola Marymount Lions and the UNLV Running Rebels. And now let's meet the starting lineups. For Loyola Marymount, at forward, a 6'5 senior from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, number 30, Bo Kimble. For UNLV, at forward, a 6'8 junior from Pasadena, California, number 32, Stacey Augmon. For Loyola Marymount, at forward, a 6'7 junior from Södertälje, Sweden, number 4, Pears Steamer. For UNLV, at forward, a 6'7 junior from Dallas, Texas, number 4, Larry Johnson. For Loyola Marymount, at center, a 6'9 sophomore from Los Angeles, California, number 34, Chris Knight. For UNLV, at center, a 6'10 senior from Washington, D.C., 00, David Butler. For Loyola Marymount, at guard, a 6'1 junior from Riverside, California, number 32, Tony Walker. For UNLV, at guard, a 6'1 and 1/2 inch sophomore from Detroit, Michigan, number 12, Anderson Hunt. For Loyola Marymount, at guard, a 6'2 senior from Newport Beach, California, number 21, Jeff Fryer. For UNLV, at guard, a 6'2 junior from Las Vegas, Nevada, number 50, Greg Anthony. And introducing the head coaches for Loyola Marymount in his fifth season, Paul Westhead. For UNLV in his 17th season, Jerry Tarkanian.
Jerry Tarkanian looking for his third trip to the Final Four. Back with the opening tip in a moment.
And they have captured three, but it was tough against Ball State, 69-67.
James Burr, the veteran referee from Latham, New York, working with Rusty Heron. Durham, North Carolina, and Tom Rucker of Birmingham, Michigan, look for this game to be officiated closely at the start as Vegas controls right off the top. Augmon and Johnson play catch. Augmon with the game's first shot.
And what we see right off the bat is that Knight's going to try to handle Johnson.
A driving layup ties the scores. Tony Walker, who will wear 32 instead of number 12. He lost the jersey number 12. Those of you who are familiar with this team. So Walker is in 32, and it did not take the Lions long to pull the trigger. Did it inside to Big Johnson, and it's a lead. That's the man that they're going to have difficulty stopping on the blocks.
And obviously, Knight, no chance in there if he plays behind him, but they're going to just try to wear Johnson down.
Stacey Augmon, a great defender, is taking Bo Kimble. He's number 32. Kimble wearing 30, hasn't touched it. Jeff Fryer hits his first shot of the game. Long pass, turn it over. Las Vegas trying to hit Anderson Hunt, and it's out of bounds.
That's exactly what Paul Westhead would want, even if it hadn't been an errant pass, because what it does is establishes that tempo.
Walker sets the table. Steamer out to screen at the top of the key. Fryer, number 21. Knight is 34. He hasn't handled it. And a moving pick at the top by Steamer. And there is that tight call at the beginning of this game. They want to set the tone for it right away.
Just full court, man-to-man pressure. Trying to force tempo. They'll even give you two to get the ball back quickly.
Anthony, the point man, out of Las Vegas, transferred out of Portland. Hunt now goes inside to Butler on the smooth turnaround.
And I think they may have to change and put Steamer over on Johnson, Knight on Butler.
Knight taking his first shot, missing the left-hander. Off now quickly to Hunt. It's a three-on-two, and Hunt pulls up the three. That's the missing link for UNLV in this tournament. They will be lethal if they find someone to bury the three from the perimeter. Whip it inside, turn it over. Ogden with the interception and a foul, a reach back. Number one on Kimble. And Westhead immediately knows he's going to go to his bench and look early in this game.
Brent, not many teams have a player like Stacey Augmon that can move and play defense against any one of five position players. Low post, a point guard, wing people, or in this particular case, the nation's leading scorer in Bo Kimble.
They go to trap Anthony, but they get it across easily into Hunt's hands. UNLV starts out perfect from the floor. They have hit their first four shots. Anthony hesitates, takes the three, and now they're 5 of 5 with two threes. Fryer answers with a three. High Butler pulling it away. Vegas rebound, and the third foul going against Loyola Marymount, and this one is on Walker.
You see the rebound on Fryer's shot going way up in the air. Butler and Johnson just too physical on the inside and too big for Loyola Marymount.
This is Tarkanian. Lois watching from the stands. Danny Tarkanian.
He doesn't have to.
There watching a former point guard for the running Rebs. And now the ball will be out of bounds, UNLV.
Using Johnson and Butler to help bring the ball up.
Johnson in difficulty will send it to Butler. He'll bring it 2-on-1 to Hunt. They are perfect from the field. UNLV starting off with that look in their eyes. Steamer traveled off the face.
Right in the first game between these two teams, there were some runs very similar to this. A 22-4 run that Loyola Marymount had on Vegas, and yet Vegas came back. So this is not surprising, this type of up-tempo game.
He scored the last 10 points. Hunt will go again. Not that time, but Johnson yanks down the rebound, and Hunt says, I'll keep shooting. This is two in a row, and now Steamer with a defensive board into Walker's hand. Coming through, and ships deflected Anthony. Loose ball, tracked down Vegas. Here comes Augmon.
The best finisher in college basketball.
Quickly off the floor now to Lowry, who had checked into the game. Terrell Lowry, number 20, out of the Oakland area, grew up about 9 miles from here.
Greg, Anthony has something wrong with his mouth, and he's asked the ref to stop the clock a second.
Fryer hits a three, and we should update you on that story. He broke his jaw in two places back on February 12th. He took a horrible crash. There was speculation that he would be out 4 to 6 weeks. He practiced the next day and played 3 days later in a game, prompting coach Jerry Tarkanian to call him the toughest player he's ever had. Now that jaw is still wired shut, but the wires are loosened before the games now, allowing 30% mobility. So obviously a problem with that. Augmon with a miss coming back, stripped now by the Lions, and Kimble brings it back. Bo Kimble trying to get on the scoreboard with muscle in for his first shot. Yanked away by Sianovic, who replaced Anthony, the backup point guard. Lowry strips it from him in the corner, spins inside. This yanked away by Butler, and the foul again going against Loyola Marymount. They get into early foul trouble.
Paul Westhead on the officials as he does early in the ball game, wanting that hand checking, particularly when somebody is going for a basket, put under control.
So four team fouls on Loyola and none yet on UNLV. Hunt into the paint. 7 points for Anderson Hunt. Lowry hits night on the break.
Well, Westhead couldn't like the pace any more to his liking than what we're seeing right now.
Sianovic having some difficulty gives it up, but it's Johnson helping out in the backcourt. Now it's Augmon. Six for Augmon. Kimble, who retreated quickly.
Johnson filled the lane beautifully.
31. Time to take a breath. We finally got a timeout.
Four Loyola Marymount players defensively. Ball comes out. Augmon fills the lane. Anderson Hunt fills the lane. The traditional two-on-one break coming up right here. Good overlive pass. Takes it on in. Anderson Hunt with a beautiful layup, and he may not be able to finish as good as Augmon, but very close.
Over on the Las Vegas bench, they continue to work on Greg Anthony's mouth. He is not yet back in the lineup, so Sianovic continues to operate at point guard.
Zone defense by Loyola Marymount.
And Another foul against Loyola, and this one is going to send Augmon up to the free throw line. And there is some of the treatment that Anthony has received with that jaw wired shut. And then it's loosened a little bit for each game, but it needed adjustment. And he had to come out of the lineup. And checking in for Loyola Marymount is Tom Peabody out of Santa Ana. He transferred from Rice. Team fouls are becoming a huge factor here. Five against Loyola and none yet against UNLV. Stacey Augmon doing the job defensively. Pope Kimble is scoreless in the early going. And Augmon has chipped in 7 points offensively. Interesting story. Last night, Bo Kimble called Stacey Augmon in his hotel room and said, get a lot of sleep. He was joking with him, and it's obvious that Stacey Augmon thought it was pretty good advice. He looks like a well-rested warrior right now.
Kimble had 21 in the first game.
There's a three for the Lions.
And off the bench, Lowry had 15 in the first game, so he finds UNLV to his liking. They go back to man-to-man. Showed the zone one time down.
Chris Scott has also checked in. UNLV and Anderson Hunt missing, and Kimble off with the rebound. Lowry pulls it up. Hits another one. Two quick ones in a row. And just like that, the Lions climb back in it. There's Augmon. Scott comes over on him defensively. Misses underneath. And now it's going the other way as Jones muscled in. That's James Jones playing because of David Butler's back problems. And they're going to try Butler right away. And Greg Anthony is coming back into the game. Number 50, Greg Anthony, returns to the lineup.
And Brent, with a sore back, as anybody knows, you don't want to sit down long. Jerry Tarkanian goes back to his amoeba defense, which works so effectively against Ball State and also against Loyola Marymount in the first game.
Butler picked up his first foul. Using the previous trip, Cianovich just put Tarkanian right in his seat.
That's the first charge Jerry has drawn since the Fresno State days. Oh, good job, Butler. UNLV defense.
Hunt breaks out with two on him and comes through. That's 9 points. Now, Anderson Hunt lit the Lions up in their first meeting. He scored 26, and he breaks out strong again. Foul is called. And it's going to be UNLV ball again.
Brent, we talk about finishers on the break. Anderson Hunt is not the size, obviously, of Stacey Augmon, but for a guard, he can finish both with the jump shot and take it in on the dunk.
Tony Walker checking back in because that's two fouls on Terrell Lowry. Well, Johnson helping them out of the backcourt, and they quickly, on two passes, get it into Augmon's hands. And he puts it away. Well scouted. They're breaking that full court press rather handily. Coming back at Walker, and a blocking foul is going to be called on Anthony. And they quickly draw him away. The jaw wired shut and all. He has picked up three technical fouls. And Anthony was yanked away by his teammate, so he wouldn't say anything to the official. Anthony not agreeing with that call.
You can see how quick Walker is. He just penetrates right with the dribble. One of the quickest men with the ball in college basketball.
A human bruise, as he's known. Peabody throws it to the corner. Butler with the miss. Run down for the loose ball, and Johnson comes up with a handle. A long baseball pass. Oh, what a beautiful pass. And an intercept now by Hunt.
Everybody ran away from Steamer. No passing lane.
Cross, and Anthony moves it quickly and then gets it back. He'll take the three.
They both are ready to shoot.
Into Peabody's hands. Walker gives it up. Kimble scores, but he couldn't get it to fall. Off now into Augmon's hands, and it is Peabody. Dive for the loose ball. Fryer up with it.
Beautiful stop dribble that time by Walker.
One of the few times they've pulled it back out all game long. Trying to get Kimble into that scoring column. Butler over on him.
Butler can play some D out on the perimeter as well.
Peabody dives for the loose ball. Here's Kimble again. They move it to Fryer. Fryer gets inside. Augmon! And it's Johnson coming away with it. Trapped in the corner. And a foul is going to be called.
I think it's going to be Kimble. I think it's his second.
Number two on Bo Kimble.
Fred, you see in practice so often teams drill with the baseball pass. You'll never see one thrown any better than the one Larry Johnson hits Stacey Augmon right on the letters.
And at 12:45, UNLV is shooting 1-1. Loyola Marymount into early foul trouble here.
Fred, well, why don't you see the big players from UNLV starting to walk down the court? So the fatigue factor will definitely get to you in a game of this pace. In the first game, the score at halftime found Loyola Marymount ahead by two, 54-52.
Knocked out of bounds by Hunt. Lions ball. Moses Scurry, number 35, into the lineup, as is Barry Young. Johnson will sit down here and take a breather.
And they go back to the zone, the amoeba defense, without Augmon or Johnson in there. Kimball's got to figure out a way to get free, Brent, for some outside shots.
Young, Butler, and Scurry on that forward wall. Kimble gets in for his first field goal of the game.
Notice how he used that upper body to knock Young right out of the way.
Almost stolen by Peabody. Hunt gets it back. Now it is Young from the perimeter. Good outside shooter, so they have to respect him. And they go inside out. It'll be Butler on a quick turnaround. The one and Reb build an early lead. Peabody missing with the three. Young the rebound. Off quickly to Anthony. It's 3-on-2. And Scurry will wait for help. Lost out of bounds, Lions ball. We'll take a break here. 11:45, and UNLV, the number one seed in the West, builds an early lead. What a tournament this has been. Seven games decided by 1 point. The record, Duke going to the third straight Final Four, Arkansas for the first time since 78, and Georgia Tech for the first time ever, Billy.
Brent, interesting, we only have one number one seed left, and that's UNLV, of course, and the ACC has knocked off the three number one seeds, North Carolina, Oklahoma, Connecticut goes out by Duke, and of course, Georgia Tech took care of Michigan State.
All uphill for Loyola Marymount now. Pryor missing the three, and UNLV off with still another rebound.
Kimball's got to be careful with those three. He plays aggressive on both ends of the floor.
Anthony's three.
This UNLV club, perimeter shooting. You cannot pick up that third foul as Kimble, and you've got to watch him both in the offensive and the defensive end.
Lowry missing as the Vegas defense attacks the perimeter aggressively with superior size. They have held Kimble to 2 points.
But they're getting a lot of wide rebounds against the zone.
And then they break out. Anthony for a driving layup.
Smart play by Kimble. There he was. He realizes that he can't get any further foul trouble.
17 points by the Rebel guards here in the early going. And now it's Hunt for the three. Into the hands of Peabody. Pryor. And Steamer coming away with it. Lowry muscling in. That's 8 points for Lowry. And they get it back on the steal. Peabody over to Lowry.
Peabody's everywhere for the loose ball.
Lowry again, and he's keeping them in there. That's 11 points and three threes for the young man from Oakland.
Jerry Tarkanian ready to come back with three subs. Anderson Hunt has not been out. He played 39 minutes, which is incredible, against Loyola Marymount in the first game.
Scurry left alone on the inside.
Kimble for three.
Bingo. His first three, five for the game.
Your normal tendency as a defensive player is to get back down court and get in the paint. When you play Loyola Marymount, you can't afford to do that. You've got to play the perimeter.
Hunt. Takes it away and then lost the handle into the corner, and Steamer touched it. UNLV ball. The matchup's next Saturday. Two ACC teams, and why not? From the beginning of this tournament until the Final Four, they have been the dominant conference. Arkansas represents the Southwest, and a marvelous job turned in by Texas. They were eliminated yesterday by Nolan Richardson's team.
They're giving Stacey Augmon the outside jumper. They've got to give up something to protect inside on Johnson.
Travis Bice, number 13, had checked in. Good block by Knight, but Augmon gets it back on the inside. Oil the ball. Steamer's three from NBA range. And you know, that's somewhat confusing for the players in a college game to have the two lines out there. We noticed the other night that that affected them in the regional semifinals. Now here is Bice. Good ball movement to Jones from Johnson. That second pass, so important.
Right, as a starter, Jones had 14 against him in the first game, so although he got moved out of the lineup when Butler came back, he did have good success.
Peabody across to Jeff. And they finally find Steamer for the three. Goes to Loyola Marymount. Ball appeared to be touched last by a Lion player. Might have been about the
referee. I think the referee said it was his fault and he's going to change the call.
That's what it looked like from here, but there were a lot of bodies between me and where it went out of bounds. So we can straighten out and take a timeout here. We've got 7:48 to go in the first half. UNLV fell a victory short. They've added Larry Johnson, and here they have dominated Loyola Marymount in the early going of this regional final. Billy, they've hit 63%.
Not surprising. Loyola Marymount gives up 52% on the year. Not many teams win games like they do with that type of defensive percentage, but they don't mind giving it up if they can get their threes going. So far today, they haven't been able to.
Ball knocked out of bounds. UNLV ball.
And Brent, one of the reasons for that is the tremendous defensive pressure on the perimeter that Jerry Tarkanian has established against his club.
Shot clock is frozen, and now it goes.
Probably picked up about 3 seconds on that. He just did get it over the 10-second line.
Bice to the baseline. Snapped away by Jones. Johnson underneath, and there's a push.
Of course, if Larry Johnson just makes contact with Knight, it's a push. You're talking about 250 like a rock against about 175 like a thin weed.
Looking for some threes with Jeff Fryer shot in and out, and Johnson pursues it, and here's Augmon. Lead to Bice. He missed it. He rushed it.
Great hustle by Walker to put pressure on him.
It's Knight.
You know what happened there? Jones thought he was a right-hander. He went up to block the right-handed jumper, and obviously the left-handed shot worked.
Bice missing with a three. Tapped by Augmon, but over to Fryer. Now it's Walker.
Looking to go back.
Blocking foul against UNLV, and that basket, it counts.
And Brent, what I sense right now is UNLV is getting a little tired. Loyola Marymount moving the ball up and down the court the way they want to, and you can see Larry Johnson playing from the top of the key to the top of the key.
I think Lois Tarkanian is sensing it too. Did you catch that shot of her in the stands?
Well, I don't see Lois pulling out the beads yet. That's, you know, it's Sunday, and she can work them.
Terrell Lowry return at the line.
This is what we were talking about at the top of the show, where Paul Westhead says, it takes my club a month to get in running shape. They're there now.
That was the first Loyola Marymount free throw of the opening half. Peabody couldn't steal it from Butler, and he was in for the easy layup, which counts, and now he'll move up to that free throw line.
Good call on that one, Brent. You saw the tremendous concentration by Butler as Peabody tried to come around behind him. You'll see it right here. Butler just goes up with the two hands, concentrates not on the defender, but making sure he makes the catch. All-conference performer, nation's number one junior college player 2 years ago, and sure to be an outstanding pro.
Missing at the line.
Doesn't look like his back's bothering him.
Kimball's three is on the money. That's eight for Bo Kimble. Brings it in on Steamer and then pulls it back out. Deflected and stolen by Lowry, who has done a fabulous job off the Lions bench. Now it's Kimble on the pull-up. Get it to fall, and Anthony going after the rebound. And he is fouled.
Brent, that's so tough to do what Bo Kimble did there. Going full speed, catch the ball, thrown right to you in your chest, and then stop and go straight up for the jump shot. One of the toughest shots to make in basketball. Of course, some of the stats that Kimball has had this year, the three straight 50-point-plus games in a row. He and Hank Adder scoring 40 each in a ball game this year. First time it's ever been done in college basketball.
Peabody with a bounce to Kimball. Augmon will dribble it out. They've turned it over on the travel, so it will go to the Lions out of bounds underneath their own basket.
You notice whenever Loyola Marymount double teams, they never reach in for the ball. They keep their hands really active, their feet active. Just a great double team there.
Deep to Fryer.
2-3 zone now. They're out of the amoeba.
One way to get back. Three. That one's short. He tracks it down, and he was fouled. So next Saturday, our road to the Final Four preview at 5 o'clock, and then the national semifinals. One match is already set. Duke against Arkansas, and Georgia Tech will play the winner of this game. One thing to keep in mind in a game like this, when you shoot a lot of three-point shots, you get long rebounds like that one right there. And that's one thing you have to keep in mind when you play a Loyola Marymount team, Billy, is that you're going to get a lot of balls ricocheting deep off the rim. You're not going to get some of those soft rolls from the close shot.
Exactly. Takes away some of the advantage of size for people that are used to going for the ball with quickness. It really makes them valuable.
Now, Fryer has been struggling at 3 points. One of eight. They get it back, and Kimble coming up is fouled by Johnson.
So quick to the ball.
And for the first time in this regional, Bo Kimble will be coming up to the free throw line. Inside to Kimble. Johnson fouling him, and so now once again Bo Kimble will move to the line, and in honor of his late teammate Hank Gathers, he'll shoot this first one left hand. He is perfect. Circle an emotional moment in this game. It came at 5:20 first half. Hunt gives it up to Augmon on the inside. Scott is there defensively, and UNLV pulls it out, Billy.
Scott doing a great job as a safety man on that press.
Johnson gets to the glass. No answer for that big, strong fella on the inside. But there's
somebody that they haven't solved at the other end. Terrell Lowry of Oakland, California, doing some job for the Lions. A reach in by Fryer, who commits that personal foul, his second.
Brent, Lowry was the Oakland High School Player of the Year. Very much underrated talent. Number two assist man in the WCC behind his teammate Troy Walker. Just an outstanding backcourt player. And really fits the mold of what Paul Westhead wants in the yard, pushing it up the floor.
The bonus free throw, and UNLV was shooting that bonus early in the game, and Paul Westhead working on referee Jim Burr, who was on the far side of the floor. And it's Hunt's possession for the runner Revs again.
If you have to use Butler back there to get the ball inbound, you have a difficult time setting up the double low post.
Anthony's three. Now it'll be Lowry, and he turns it over. It's Augmon lead, Anthony breakout. And he drew a foul from Scott.
Excellent body contact that time. He knew that he had Scott on his hip. You see it right here. He takes Scott on his hip and then extends at the last minute for the shot, making it impossible to block. Great job by Anthony. You can see the extension perfectly there.
Billy, after the free throw was hit left-handed by Bo Kimble, UNLV came on strong. They did not allow that moment to turn this game around. Steamer on the inside driver.
You're exactly right, Brent. And that was a moment when you figured that they had captivated this crowd, but it didn't turn over.
The Lions have turned it over 12 times. Walker will replace Lowry, who played his heart out.
Well, Tony Walker pushed the ball up court quickly as well.
Score it, and it's a blocking foul on Steamer.
Up to that point, Steamer and Scott have been able to keep Stacey Augmon from penetrating with the dribble, making him pull up for the jumper, which he didn't want to take, but Augmon is so good at taking the ball to the hoop. Good defense, but just a little better offense.
A 16-point performance, make it 17 for the Olympian. Body has it knocked away, and he was fouled. That's two on Anthony.
Body, a high school teammate of Tommy Lewis and Leron Ellis, of course, from Syracuse, the team that got knocked out of the tournament. Somewhat of a surprise.
Solution for him in the paint off the glass. He has been a force rebounding now. Seven rebounds for him. Kimball, and it stayed in.
Some touch, almost beyond the NBA three-point line.
It's 13 points for Bo Kimball. Augmon coming in, he slipped and turned it over.
Good defense by Steamer.
So we've got a break. 3.5 minutes in the first half. UNLV leading it by 14.
Should be available.
There's Johnson. A man's man.
Can't stop him.
Johnson.
Kimball has to give it up. Peeble. Short. Vegas ball again. Stolen by Kimball in the corner, and then Johnson retrieves it for the Rebels. Up the court to Hunt. Augmon's on his left. Beautiful.
32.
2.5 minutes. Kimball. Rolled out, and Butler Butler going for the rebound was fouled by Walker.
And Brent, going back to the point you made, after Bo Kimble hit that left-handed free throw, it has been all UNLV. Amazing, this emotional run on their part to show that they could handle anything that Loyola Marymount could put on them, particularly when you figure they'd be tired.
Bo Kimble made it 41-35.
Down six.
And it looked like that might provide the emotional spark in this game.
And they've outscored them by 12 points since that point. Now you notice what Tark is doing here. He's not putting fellas on the foul line. He wants all his fellas to do two things. Number one, rest by already being back. And number two, be in a position to guard defensively against somebody who wants to push it up the court quickly.
And Tarkanian wants a timeout.
Can't get it unless they make the shot.
I think he wanted it before that second free throw. And he'll take it if they hit a successful basket here. Pryor takes his game inside. And it's going to go to Loyola Marymount. I guess the ball hit too high on that glass backboard. You know, Billy, one of the things that you were telling me, you love the clock situation here in the Oakland Coliseum, where you've got the game clock and the shot clock directly above the glass backboard here so that the players never lose contact. You said that's a problem in some arenas.
It really is. I think it's a great move. And also the red light is up there so that the officials can see it well when we get down to the buzzer time, which so many games, as we know, 23 have ended by less than 3 points in this tournament.
Another great defensive play. Now Tarkanian gets his timeout. Johnson knocks the ball out of bounds, so we've got a dead ball situation, and here come UNLV cheerleaders. Tarkanian gave that city, and it was something to rally behind. I think that somewhat gets overlooked by everyone. Focuses in on some of the problems that they have had through the years down there, but this is really a rallying point for an entire city. And wherever in UNLV, what they want to do most of all is climb the mountain. Tarkanian is in familiar territory here in the West. There's no question about that. Sweet 16 eight times. And he's made it three times into the final eight. And he has gone to the final four twice. Now, he has not yet won the national championship. And this is what Jerry Tarkanian wants more than anything in the world. The man's entire life is basketball. Let me give you an anecdote. Harry Belafonte had some coveralls on over at a hotel once, and Jerry Tarkanian was introduced to him, and he actually thought that Harry was one of the janitors of the hotel. The man doesn't live anything but basketball. 2 minutes to go here in the first half, and Tarkanian's running Rebs have things under control, even though Loyola stormed back. Kimble on the turnaround. Ooh, Johnson went down hard to the floor, and then wrestling with the ball, a held ball situation, and it's UNLV's possession, but he took a nasty fall, Billy.
He really did. He came down almost in a scissors split. UNLV officials are going to allow him to stay down there on the floor till he gets himself organized. And obviously, you're going to see when he comes down here. This was quite a spill for a guy 250. Look at those great hands that he has. Makes the catch while laying on the floor.
Steamer. That's his first field goal of the game. Anthony gets it back to Butler. The big man has to help out. Johnson under pressure. Hunt will dribble it up.
Good job by Greg Anthony. Get his club back in sync. Try to get the ball down low now to two people, Butler and Johnson. The Loyola Marymount has not been able to play with. Smart move here by Jerry Tarkanian. He's one of the few teams in America that could be prepared for Loyola Marymount in only one day because he doesn't have to alter that much of his own style.
Butler at the shot clock. Augmon on the inside with a putback. Butler just did get it off. And then you get a fresh 45 as soon as you released it. Stolen now by Augmon, who's played like an Olympian here in the first half.
Beautiful job by Stacey Augmon. He used his shoulder to keep Steamer pushed away and then finished again.
He's outscored Cole Kimble 23-16. Kimble's third three of the game. And now it's Augmon's turn. Lights out for Augmon. And Kimble objecting to how he's defended. And Anthony with a few words for him after he pulled away from that situation.
That was a great help on defense. Kimble probably could have got that shot off against Anthony, but Johnson came over to help out.
Billy, you said to keep an eye on one stat, and that's a shooting percentage. UNLV hitting better than 60% in this game, and Loyola only 39%.
They can still live with those percentages, Brent, but they have got to figure out a way to stop the low post play. The 33 from three is the same as 50 from two. Playing against the zone again. Jerry Tarkanian spent a lot of zone in his first half.
Lowry. Run down by Butler. That's the end of the first half. And for UNLV, Jerry Tarkanian's running Rebs. It's 20 minutes to Denver. And CBS sports coverage of the NCAA basketball championship will continue after this message and a word for your local.